Definite article in Arabic is used differently than it is in English. It means the whole genus, the whole category. And in fact, all the praise goes to Allah. In fact, everything goes back to Allah. Everything starts with Allah and everything goes back to Allah. Right? Alhamdulillah. Right? All the praise. None of the praise resides with us. All the praise resides with Allah. Rabbil Alameen. You know, Alameen comes from the word ilm. Ilm. You know, there's nothing precious, nothing more precious than Allah can give you than knowledge. The Prophet, peace be upon him, the only thing he asked for increase was knowledge, not faith, knowledge. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Imam Muhammad translated this, nurturer and sustainer of the all the systems of knowledge, right? It could be translated, all that is known. All those things that we can recognize in the creation, right? So praise be to Allah, cherisher and sustainer of all the worlds. May the prayers and peace be upon the prophets and the messengers, all of them, and upon our dear Muhammad 1400 years ago, and upon his family, and upon his companions, upon all the Muslims and non-Muslims, and what follows. There's a verse in the Quran that says, وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٌ. And the scholars have debated about this ayah. I'll give you both translations. And over everyone endowed with knowledge is one with a small o, more knowing. That means whatever you may know, someone knows something more than you do. Right? You're never top dog, right? There's a dog above you, or a horse, or whatever the slang is nowadays, right? The other one is, and over everyone endowed with knowledge is one with a capital O, more knowledgeable, meaning Allah. And we know that Allah is more knowledgeable than everyone, right? Yes, alhamdulillah. Also it says in the Quran, وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَكُمْ خَلَائِفَ الْأَرْضِ وَرَفَعَ بَعْدَكُمْ قَبْلَ بَعْدٍ دَرَجَاتٍ وَيَبْلُوَكُمْ فِيمَا آتَاكُمْ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ سَرِيعُ الْعِقَابِ وَإِنَّهُ لَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And he has made you caretakers of the earth, Khalifa, that you're supposed to take care of his earth, right? Like guardians. Like guardians, right? And he has raised some of you, speaking now to all mankind, he has raised some of you above others in degrees. The important part is what comes next. So that he may test you. So that he may test you in what he has given you. Right? So he made some more knowledgeable than the others in order to test them, how they would use their knowledge. And he made some less intelligent than others so that he may test them. Right? Mm-hmm. Knowledge has to be respected in whatever house it may reside in. And those who don't know have to respect those who know. And those who know have a responsibility to teach those who don't know. They have a responsibility. That's their test. They have to make clear what this book means. Clear. You have to take all that baggage that exists around the Quran, all that tafsir literature. You have to begin reading the Quran, the words in the Quran. This is crucial. People don't read the Quran anymore, even in Arabic. They read the words, but they're listening to some tafsir, some mufassir, who's made some comment on the Quran. And so they don't read the words anymore, because what resonates in their head is someone else's words, not Allah's words. And what he has given you, indeed your Lord is swift in reckoning. And to him is the mercy and the forgiveness. Prophet Muhammad said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allahumma arina ashya kama hiya. Oh my God, cause us to see things as they really are. Cause us to see things as they really are. There's a quote by Ibn Arabi that says, speaking of Allah, he governs the world, meaning the creation, through itself. He governs the world through itself. We don't believe in miracles, or we shouldn't believe in miracles in Islam. He governs the world through itself. Through what? Through the laws of creation that have already been created. There are laws in creation. The laws that govern the material world. He created the material world. He doesn't need to create any other laws. He doesn't need to intercede in the creation he has already created because it's perfect. He created the laws in the creation. That is to say, the physical laws that govern this creation, which science has been able to reveal a few of them to us. They know very little about the physical creation. Very, very little. The Quran says, لا تتركه El Absaru. Wa huwa yutriku al absara. Wa huwa latiful khabir. Qad ja'akum basairu min rabbikum faman absara fa amin fali nafsihi wa man 'amiya fa 'alayha wa ma ana alaykum bihafizin. They're seeing, and this could be seeing with the physical eyes or seeing in terms of insight. This word basara implies both. Their seeing does not perceive him, speaking of Allah, while he encompasses all their seeing. For he is the most subtle, the all-aware. They have already come to you, all spiritual insights from your Lord. Talking about this long chain of revelation that has come from Allah, including the long chain of revelation that all the prophets have brought, that was finalized with Muhammad. So whoever was seen, that is for the good of his soul. And whoever was blind, that is against it. And I am not a keeper for you all. Quoting from a book called The Reflective Heart by James Wilson, he's a scholar in religious studies. He says, quoting from the Quran, part of it, "Is not the pure religion holy gods, since any other form of religion is inevitably corrupted either by promptings of the egoistic self or its concern with social propriety. Groupthink dominates the Middle East. Groupthink dominates us. Tribalism. Tribalism leads to cannibalism, right? Syrians are eating one another. And now the Lebanese have entered the fray. Based on tribalism, not religion. Unquote. Some people will say, why do you need to know this or that? Why learn Arabic? You know, we got good translations. Why learn Arabic? Why waste your time, right? And speaking Arabic is not knowing Arabic, not Quranic Arabic, right? You take the word heart in Arabic, right? You take the word heart in English. There's only one word for it. In Arabic, there are multiplicity of words in the Quran that talk about this notion, the heart, satrum, the chest, right? The chest expands and contracts. Qalb, al-qalbun, the heart, right? The heart is inside the chest, right? And qalbun comes from a root that means to turn over. You're constantly turning, you know, shifting from position to position. A state of consciousness, one state of consciousness to another state of consciousness. Fu'adun. So also another word that's translated for heart, right? Comes from a root, right? Which means to strike or hit something, you know? You know, when something really strikes you and hits you and moves you emotionally, you know? Like your art and desire, you know? Every time you come in contact with that thing, you have a physical reaction to it or a mental or emotional reaction to it. That's what fu'ad means. That's the nature of that heart, right? Then you have lubbun, right? The very essence of something, right? And all of these are aspects talking about the same internal reality, right? These are aspects talking about this same internal space. So, some people will say, why do you need to know this or that? Just do what we are doing. There's no need to follow your heart and intellect just do what the masses are doing. And the people won't single you out for ridicule. Do what your family tells you to do. You know? Do what your tribe tells you to do. So they won't ridicule you. They won't single you out. You know? Don't turn your face to Allah. Turn your face to tribalism. But you must follow your heart and your intellect. If Allah is to open up to you the special secrets He has hidden in it, especially only for you. Quoting from the same book, he quotes the hadith of the Prophet. Just as light drives away all darkness, so the ritual prayer cuts off every other preoccupation. Unlike other acts of devotion, which do not involve letting go of everything other than Allah, as the ritual prayer does. So you can do other activities when you're fasting or when you're making the Hajj. You can have other concerns. But when you're lost in prayer, you can't. There's supposed to be a one-on-one communication between you and Allah. And you should be listening to what Allah has to say to you. Your heart. This is why prayer is called a light. In the famous hadith, prayer is a light. Because in that way, it gives the servant the good news that if he confides in God and entrusts himself to Him through His name, and Nur, the light, one of the attributes of Allah, then he is alone with His servant and removes every transient thing, all the creation. Mm-hmm. He's absorbed in the presence of God. In the servant's act of witnessing Him during their intimate conversation. There are two kinds of purification. That purification that comes from faith, and another that comes from knowledge. So purify yourself with both. You know, ritual causes chronological time, what we call chronological time, you know, one step in front of the other, sequential time, to drop off. Since you are one with eternity and eternity is one with you, or you have the potential to become one with eternity. There are people in Africa called the Dogon people who perform a ritual every 57 years. And the ritual itself lasts for a period of 7 years. And the whole society and culture participates in this ritual. It is a ritual of transformation. In fact, all rituals for the purpose are for the purposes of transformation. All of them. If you're not transformed when you perform a ritual, then you haven't truly performed a ritual. You're just going through the motions, you're exercising. You know, it has become custom. It's no longer a ritual. It is a ritual of transformation. In fact, all rituals are for the purposes of transformation. The individual has to die to something and come alive to something else. In this ritual of the rite of passage of the Dogon people, the entire society and culture dies metaphorically and are reborn spiritually with a new life. This is what happens in the transformation in the social. This is what happened in the transformation in the social, spiritual, and psychic life of the people of the Nation of Islam. Talking about Elijah Muhammad and the movement that he created that produced people like me and people who were sitting on the floor, a new mind. To the true spirituality of Al-Islam, with a capital A, not with a small A, right? Taslim, you know, submission to the will of God, surrender to the will of God. Not this kind of formal fiqh thinking, very literal in its application of the religion. But there's nothing here, just rules and regulations. A lot of rules, little mercy. Mm-hmm. And Allah says that my mercy is more than my wrath. See, I don't have to answer to anyone. I don't have anyone paying me to do this. So I don't have to answer to anyone. And I'm not bound by custom and tradition, so I don't have to answer to that either. And my people understand. We should celebrate this transformation we experienced as individuals and as a community. This is what Savior's Day was a sign or a symbol pointing to in the first. It was pointing to the true transformation which would take place in the second. Ritual can invoke history, which is not bound by time. It can invoke a sense of timelessness. In fact, time disappears when the sacred is unfolding. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, work for this world as if you will live forever. Get your share of this material world. You have a responsibility to get your share of this material world. He says, work for this world as if you will live forever. And then he says, and work for the hereafter as if you're going to die tomorrow. And that is the balance. You know the Quran says, paraphrasing the Quran now, that he who loses his share in this world and the hereafter has had a mighty loss. Because he got neither of either. There is permanence within the ritual itself. Although it points to the changelessness, the changing, things changing, constantly changing. You know, there's a concept in Buddhism called impermanence. Because everything in creation is constantly changing. But on a higher order of thinking, on a higher order of Buddhist thinking, they call this same experience the great permanence. permanence. Because everything is changing. That is the reality of realities. But it's our inability to see that the cause, that which causes our pain, and that is what causes our pain and suffering, is kind of constant changing. It's kind of constant taqlib within the nature of the heart. As the Quran says, expressing both of these aspects of reality, فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْأُسْرِ يُسْرًا إِنَّ مَعَ الْأُسْرِ يُسْرًا Verily with difficulty there is ease. Verily with difficulty there is ease. The nature of life is this, up and down, and up and down, and up and down. This is very nature. The Quran also says, everything is perishing except the face of God. It's the only constant thing. Everything is perishing except the face of God. We all have moments of spiritual expansion, right? Alam nashra laka satraka, right? Did we not expand your chest, your heart? Did we not open up all these possibilities for you? Right? It's using the royal we, right? Addressing all of us, really. I know that the Mufassir limited only to the Prophet. And remove your burden that was on your back, right? And we will rise you up to be remembered. And verily with difficulty there is ease. Verily with difficulty there is ease. Right? And when you are empty of these concerns that preoccupy you in your life, right? I'm just translating the verse, the surah in English. Right? Then strive hard. Right? But to your Lord, to the one who nurtured and sustained you, right? Make that your final goal and desire. We all have moments of spiritual expansion and moments of spiritual contraction. But we should understand that in those moments of contraction lay the seeds of a future expansion of the soul. If we would only listen to what our heart and intellect has to tell us. One of the attributes of Allah is al-haq. Some have said that it embodies all of the other attributes. Al-haq. It is usually translated as truth or the real. But it is the true reality that informs all life. And we ought to strive to have some understanding of what that true reality is. And whatever you come to know of what that true reality is, then the task is to implement it in your life. Then Allah will truly bless you with the favors of His creation. In fact, the goal should be to implement all of Allah's attributes in our personal and communal life. His attributes of loving mercy being one of His most embracing attributes. I was listening to the radio once and a man said, if you want to be happy, practice compassion. And if you want to make others happy, practice compassion. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. I prepared too much, but I'll stop here. I'm going to read the announcements. What's new? This Sunday, June 9th, 2013, is our annual Dawa barbecue. It will be here at Masjid Wali Muhammad, starting at 11 a.m. All meats will be provided, but we ask all community members to bring side dishes and drinks. Community Service Friends and Family Day. Community Service Friends and Family Day will be canceled. Second Saturday board meeting is tomorrow at 11:30 a.m. We ask all board members to be present. Education Committee will now meet on every second Saturday from 9 to 11:30 a.m. The last third Sunday breakfast before Ramadan is June 16th, so don't miss out. 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. Tickets are only $7. See your community service member for tickets. July 6th is Masjid Wali Muhammad's pre-Ramadan fundraising dinner from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Ticket prices to be announced. For the first 2 weeks of Ramadan, Brother Talib will be having specials on his great smelling oils. Okay? I gave that emphasis for Brother Talib. He told me, don't forget to mention my oils. Buy any four sizes of oil and you get one free. Buy 8 and you get 2 free. Or buy 12 and you get 4 free. Please support Brother Tyler and all of our vendors. The kitchen needs help in purchasing a new freezer. We are now accepting donations. The kitchen is in need of volunteers for Thursday and Friday to help prepare and clean for Friday's meal. If you are interested, please see Sister Dorothy or Brother Ibrahim. You want me to do these reminders too? Okay. So we have one more. The Dawa team of Masjid Wali Muhammad invites you to come join us on June 9th for a festive community outing, free food and fun for the family, Black History display, fun and games for the children, at Masjid Wali Muhammad. We're here, so I take it you know the address. We are providing the barbecue and grilled chicken and franks. Please bring side dishes. I think they know that. All right.
That's not for us, so I take it.
Okay. I found this for that. Oh.
Let's just read a quick one here. The Historic Designation Advisory Board of the City of Detroit will be holding a public hearing here at the Masjid next Thursday on June the 13th at 4:30. And this meeting will be to discuss the possibility of making this facility a historic landmark. So I just wanted to make sure the community heard about that. This coming Thursday at 4:30, inshallah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala falal. Qad qamat as-salat. Qad qamat as-salat. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah.
إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله من حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فلم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسر إن مع العسر يسر فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله من حمده.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Home, family, food, and finances. Did you know that taking a test before your child is born may improve the odds of your child doing well on tests?
That food allergies may make it harder to lose weight?
Or that there's a new technique to treat snoring?
Consumer Science News and Notes will explain these interesting facts and offer useful and intriguing information.
Keep a pen and paper handy. During the program, we will tell you where to send for free brochures and information packets.
The United States Fire Administration offers a few tips to help prevent fires at your home. First, don't use a kitchen oven range to heat your home during colder weather. Oven ranges can be a fire hazard and a source of toxic fumes. Keep space heaters and wood stoves at least 3 feet from anything combustible. Make sure wood stoves have proper floor support and adequate ventilation. Fireplaces must have a glass or metal screen to prevent sparks from igniting nearby carpets and furniture. Be sure that all furnace controls and emergency shutoffs work well. Leave furnace repairs to qualified specialists. Never leave cooking unattended. Double check to see that all appliances are off before going to bed or leaving the house. For more fire safety information, visit the United States Fire Administration at www.usfa.fema.gov.
More than half of all U.S. households own a pet, but one in four of these pets may wind up in an animal shelter. To make pet adoptions more successful, experts recommend that owners follow four pet pointers. First, discuss the rules of pet behavior with your family before your new pet comes home. This will improve the odds that your new pet receives a consistent message. Spay or neuter your cat or dog to prevent unwanted litters. Proper training is very important. New puppies or dogs not accustomed to staying alone can bark or howl. Get pet references from a vet, just in case you move. They may help persuade a prospective landlord that your pet will be well-behaved. A free booklet called The ABCs of Responsible Pet Ownership is available at animal shelters and humane societies. For a free copy, visit www.febreze.com.
Thank you.
Thank you.
before we move on, I just want to invite people who wish to, I mean, not sisters, but brothers, if you are able to put a little donation in for the meal, this will help us in future events. You know, again, it's an invitation, it's not a demand. But, you know, it helps future programs, inshallah, and it helps to make the programs be the best that they can possibly be, inshallah. So with that, I would like to go ahead and invite Imam Rashidin, Imam Ajib Rashidin, up to make his poetry presentation, inshallah.
I enjoyed all the presenters who filled this way up. Let me open up with, a dua. Call Rabbana, Dhanamna, Enfusina. وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And say, our Lord, we have certainly been unjust to ourselves, and if thou forgive us not and have not mercy on us, we shall certainly be of the losers. Amen. I've got a little short poem, and I wrote this a few weeks ago. I was at an event and a jazz concert, and English professor at Wayne State University has got a little band, and they were playing the tune, and they titled the tune Speaking in Tongues, and I thought the title was something that you know, I get my inspiration from just things I see and hear and whatever. So this poem, I titled it Speaking in Tongues, and it go like this. Speaking in tongues, glossolalia for orphans, whose fathers and mothers once used intelligent speech, like divine inspiration, now standing on corners of sterile conclusions, as our sons and daughters congregate in front of Arab party stores, like phosphorescent roaches needing darkness to shine. Because the audacity of hope is the state lottery where I come from. While Ahmed receives grandmama's numbers, instructions to gods and goddesses from red devil dream books, standing in the garden of their souls, seething with Thorazine dreams, seduced by the schemes of Satan that we own the night. Weakened by gasoline baptisms in the woods, memories of Jesus and burning crosses, denied a relationship with Earth, our other mother, and each other. Sharecroppers without a share. Promises without social content are still copulations without honor. A dissipating pleasure. A moist moment in a fuzzy triangle on the weekend. Religious casualties speaking in tongues. Glossolalia on the Sunday. For orphans whose ancestors once used intelligent speech. Satan not only wants to undress you like he did your parents, or want to raise our children speaking in tongues. Thank you.
All right. All right. All right.
Reverend Kelvin Franklin. All brothers, which I think is good, you know, celebration of family, right? You know, okay. And we also have some religious leaders in the Islamic community present as well. We have Imam Derek Ali. We have Imam Chris Lovelace. He's our speaker tonight. We also have Imam Rashidin. He'll be greeting you all with a nice point this evening. We have Imam Salim. And we also have Imam Abdul Mateen. And we can't forget Imam Abdullah Elamin. He's currently running for city council. It's gonna help you out. It's a start. So I would like to start this evening off with the brother Jordan Franklin. He's gonna read a verse from the Bible pertaining to family. So this should be very, very good. Jordan Franklin, give it up.
I'll start. I will be laying with our Christ's implants of young placenta.